Hello YouTube, we are going to customize Windows because my Linux friends, they keep saying that you can't do mods with Windows. So I think I will do a little series here where we customize Windows. But first, let's do a really simple nerdy thing that a lot of Linux nerds, they love to do. They love to do the NeoFetch. Well, Windows have an equipment for that also called WinFetch. It's been around for a long, long, long time. And this is the one here you can actually get custom images up there just like you can under Linux. And you do that in PowerShell. We'll get into PowerShell here. Good old PowerShell here. And you can set it to auto start and all of that. I don't want that. I don't really like NeoFetch or WinFetch. Why start your prompt with like half of the lines used that you have, you know, already chucked off and jumped up and cluttered up with stuff that, yeah, I know what my system is, you know, like I built it. I know what my system is. I don't need a reminder. And nobody's looking over my shoulder trying to be, oh, that looks cool. Nobody cares. But anyway, for the people that want to flex their EP in a little bit, we can go into the installation method here. I will have a link to this website down below. Helps if I click the damn link. And there are different ways of doing it. Using PS Gallery or PowerShell Gallery, it's kind of like PowerShell's own little repositories of add-ons, like the PIP for Python and stuff like that. And we can basically just copy this one here, right-click. We may need to remove this little indicator here. So we're using something called Install Scripts and WinFetch, and just click Enter. And it should be doing its little thing here. There you go. And it gives us up here. You don't have path in your environment, blah, blah, blah. Do we want to add it? You just give it a big old yes, because we are cool like that. And untrusted repository, again, yes. It is warning you. I really like that. And then it's installing the package. I should make a video about PS Gallery because there's a lot of great stuff in there. So if I do WinFetch, there you go. You now have my information about my virtual machine. I don't understand why people want this. Why start your terminal with all of these lines already occupied? And then you have to do a clear command, and then you can type in what you want to do. But yeah, there are people out there that want to, you know, I don't know, flex to themselves, I guess. I see this as the equivalent that, you know, I go to the gym and see all those pros standing there in front of the mirror doing all that shit. I'm like, yeah, okay, you work out. I don't give a fuck. Nobody gives a fuck about how much you're working out, you know. But yeah, it's that easy. And thousands of things like this that you can do to your terminal. You can do a lot of crazy shit. Christian Lambert, I think he's called now, the old Digital Life, has a really good video about how to customize and spice up your Windows terminal. I may link that down below also, or if you want it, let me know, and I will just not DM it to you, but respond with a link to the video where you can see what he's doing with PowerShell. You are not locked in with Windows as much as you think you are. Yeah, you cannot go in and mess with the kernel, but a lot of other things you can actually really, really do. You can go in and customize a big part of. Little quick video. If you want more videos about, you know, customizing Windows, let me know down below. And we, again, like I said, I kind of want to make a little theories about this to debunk a lot of the claims that the Linux community has made ever since I became a part of it in the mid-90s. You can do a lot with Windows, you just can't do as much as you can with Linux when it comes to customizability. See you all later, have an amazing day, and I hope this was helpful. Bye-bye.